I saw it from up the street, right there in Manhattan and Juniata. I thought I was lost. You know, I've been coming down here for 20 years. When I seen that there was like something different. You know, I'm like, wait a minute, I'm on the same street. Had check that. So, okay. Come down, seen the organizer's van right there. Now this is the place. People riding by. They didn't even notice it. I have to tell them, hey, who did that? We did this. Nah, these nice people did it.
That's JoJo. She volunteers at the New Zion Baptist Church, which shares a wall with the Manchester Growing Together Garden on Juniata Street in the Manchester neighborhood of Pittsburgh's North Side. The Manchester Gardens asked these two artists, Shane Pilster and Max Gonzalez, to build this mural. I'm Brian Crawford with pghmuseums.org, and this is Mustard Seed Faith. When I arrived, the two artists got working tracing the rooster and the sun with a brush attached to a long pole. Max described it to me like a large pencil. They started filling it in from there, but it all started a lot earlier through a lot of back and forth conversation and a lot of tech.
I drew out the rooster and some extra flowers, and then Max sketched out the whole background. I composited both of them in Photoshop, and then so we could kind of have a visual of what everything we wanted to do, and then I Photoshopped it on to the wall, like taking a photo, so we kind of get our proportions correct. And then sometimes we'll use different methods to put our design on the wall, but this time we used a roller and a roller extension, and we just sketched it out with the roller, and it was real rough, but it was just all we needed was the basic shape so we could have the proportions correct. And then we just started going at it, really.
Well, we got started, we had a farm up by Manchester School.
That's Mr. Wallace Sapp. He and his wife, Lisa Freeman, run the farm.
That's where we got started at. We partnered up with Manchester School. Now, I have had a fellowship with Manchester School called Math Doctors.
Yeah.
Where I worked on the math for the students. Then we had a garden where students from Manchester and the students from Matt would come together and plant in our garden. From there, we grew into this, where this was a building. We had this torn down and started a new episode of Manchester Growing Together.
So this is an urban farm in the north side of Pittsburgh in Manchester. So we were talking about a few different ideas, and one of the ideas that Lisa had was to have, you know, roosters and various plant life. And as soon as I heard rooster, I remember seeing some images online of a rooster that looked very similar to this with like lots of bright colors. So my brain immediately went to that. And then we had a few different revisions and exchanges back and forth, but the rooster stayed.
Yeah, and I guess since we are surrounded by three Baptist churches, it was important to keep some relevancy of faith in there. One concept that Lisa really was interested in was mustard seed faith. So I guess how small acts of religion, small acts of kindness can grow and manifest into a much larger thing. I guess we wanted flora, fauna, and the whole growth of life from there.
So despite a little danger and an essential coffee break or two, day one was at an end and a rooster had taken shape.
Day two today, what were you guys working on? Like, what was the process for today? I know there were a lot of details, a lot of detailing and adding things up. Does that take in some ways as much time as putting together the full the bird initially, the details in the project?
Yeah, absolutely. So it was a lot of rendering, there was a couple of sections on here that I wasn't happy with the textures of them. So I redid those first. Max has been working on the background nonstop, and we've just been trying to render things out to give it some more depth and dimension. We're also going to add probably a sharper black outline around the rest of the bird to give them some pop off the rest of the background and finish out everything. So been here for a few hours today. We painted for quite a while the first day.
Shane makes it sound so easy, but there was one problem. There was a hole in the wall where they were due to paint, and the project couldn't be completed until the hole was repaired. So while the garden was being tended to, the chickens were enjoying a stroll, and our artists were painting away, Lisa found someone to plug the hole up, and the work never stopped.
Yeah, and I guess the tasks are really divided by each person. Like, we both know what we need to get done. Even when we were sketching, it was very obvious, like, all right, Shane's going to knock out the rooster. I'll be doing the sun and a bit of a background. So as far as my process, day one was kind of figuring out how do I develop that background in the medium of spray paint, because every mural is something new, and I found what works best, what works easiest, and yeah, now it's just chugging away, just doing lots and lots of stalks and lots of flowers.
Yeah, he started with that section over here with the all the stalks, and then figured out a way that he liked how it was rendered, and then continued on along the bottom here, and gonna finish out the flowers like on the left side going up the top. So the bird was just, you know, we had this set up on day one, so it was easier for me to go back and forth. And then I gave Max the single ladder, so he was running up and down, so it wasn't as easy to get the background done, but that's why it's kind of, you know, that's why there's so much of the bird done, because it was just easier. These platforms are amazing, because we're about, what, like 5 feet off the ground, 6 feet off the ground. That makes it incredibly more efficient.
That's teamwork.
I was impressed with how quickly everything came together. When I saw how large the wall was, and I saw the early design, I figured I'd be filming for weeks, and I was there for 2 days. I was curious what JoJo thought of the project.
Man, like, it changed everything. You, like, lit it up. It blew, you know, it's different. This is what you need to bring it out more.
So you think this is good for the community?
Heck yeah. Heck yeah. You're going to get more people coming out, taking pictures, smiling and grinning, you know. Yeah, you know. And that's another original. You know, this is what we do. We help and we brush people, you know what I mean? Try to, you know, all in a day's work.
So after 2 days of work and lots of sunburn, the mural was finished. This is Pittsburgh Graffiti. The following was Mustard Seed Faith, a production for pghmuseums.org, presented, filmed, and edited by me, Brian Crawford. Our music is Acid Trumpet by Kevin McLeod. Special thanks to our artists, Shane and Max, Hemispheric Conversations, Urban Art Project, and Lisa Freeman. Lisa, thanks for the pizza. We'll end with a thought from Mr. William Sapp.
We have here what's called Manchester Rowing Together Garden. And we hope that you will come here and enjoy the atmosphere here. We have this new mural, a rooster coming up, because we want everybody to come here, have the ability to have a brand new day. That's what that rooster stands for. An opportunity to stand in front of that and say, hey, this is a brand new day.
Step back in time to see history through the lens of a camera with 2,000 cameras on display at the Photo Antiquities Museum of Photographic History. Historic photographs of the Civil War, Native Americans, the World Wars, lantern slides, spirit photographs, stereo views, and more are available at the Photo Antiquities Museum of Photographic History. The Photo Antiquities Museum also has a special collection of rare photos of Pittsburgh's shantytown, a makeshift poor Pittsburgh neighborhood built during the Great Depression. Throughout it all, I noticed in every picture, no one seemed to be smiling. So I asked museum founder Bruce Klein, why?
Yes, so nobody smiles because the exposure time was 30 minutes. And that's why everybody looks real stiff, because you can't hold a smile for 30 minutes. In addition to that, they usually had neck braces behind their head to keep their head in place, because, again, 30 minutes, you would move your head side to side, your photo would be blurry.
Can Bruce smile for 30 minutes?
No, I think I don't think I could do that for more than 4 or 5 minutes, I'm sure.
Explore the nation's only 19th century photography museum, including everything from the first photograph in 1821 all the way to digital, right on Pittsburgh's north side at the Photo Antiquities Museum of Photographic History. Learn more at photoantiquities.org.